Hey guys, welcome to the channel and another video. Today I'm going to be watching Kingdom of Heaven, the director's cut by the legendary Sir Ridley Scott, starring Orlando Bloom and I believe Eva Green and Liam Neeson too. I'm a huge, huge fan of Ridley Scott's work and I've watched plenty of his films over the years. There's way too many to list here, but one of my first videos was the Alien review that I did on the channel. Please check it out when you have the time. About Kingdom of Heaven, when it first came out, I kind of missed out on it. And since then, I never got around to watching it properly. I've seen it running on TV in the background. And that's how I know that it's a historical epic with elements of fiction, I believe. It's about one of the Crusades and the Siege of Jerusalem. There were like, what, 7 or 8 Crusades? So I'm not sure which one this is based on. I also believe that this movie has the famous conqueror Saladin. I remember reading about him back in history class in school, what, almost 20 years ago now? Holy crap, time flies. I'm here watching the director's cut because, as I understand it, it's the definitive version of the film at just over 3 hours. Apparently, Ridley Scott was forced to cut a lot of the film by the studio for the theatrical release, and that version got very average reviews, and I'm told that this cut is far superior to the original release. I'm not surprised. That's what happens when there's too much studio interference, too many cooks kind of spoil the broth, but I'm really, really excited to get into it. But before we do, to help support the channel, I have a Patreon page for full-length reviews and reactions to this movie and over 240 movies, 2 TV shows, early access, and weekly polls for what to watch next. You'll need your own copy to watch along, and the links in the description below. Please consider being a patron. Please subscribe to the channel. Click that bell icon for instant notifications. Do check out my other videos. Like if you like this video. Feel free to dislike it if you didn't. All that being said, let's get started. Kingdom of Heaven, Scott, Bloom. Let's go. Whoa, this movie has an overture. Holy crap, is it structured like one of those old school films? Because the last film I saw had an overture was Ben-Hur on the channel. That means I'm expecting an intermission and probably an epilogue at the end. Interesting. We get epic music. I wonder who's doing the score here. Has to be either Hans Zimmer or Henry Gregory Williams. I mean, yeah, Ridley Scott's really taking his time with the overture, trying to set the mood. I mean, it is the director's cut, right? So he has all the time in the world. Oh, now we get the traditional intro. And knowing it's a Ridley Scott production, I know that logo is scot-free. There's a lot of money involved. It's a huge budget. And he made Gladiator just a couple of years before this. Man, I wish I could rewatch Gladiator for the first time. It's almost 100 years since Christian armies from Europe seized Jerusalem. Europe suffers in the grip of repression and poverty. Peasant and lord alike flee to the Holy Land in search of fortune or salvation. So Jerusalem is in the hands of the Christians currently. France, 1184. Kingdom of Heaven. It's interesting that we get such a long intro without any names, no Ridley Scott, no Orlando Bloom, nothing. We're straight into the movie. And Ridley Scott also likes unique color palettes. In Gladiator, it was mostly yellow and orangish tones. And here, I can see bluish tones.
She's denied the cross for suicide and buried at the center of a crossroads.
Oh.
Show me their logic.
That lady committed suicide, so she's not getting a proper burial. Liam Neeson. Liam Neeson's a badass.
This is for the burial for my lord.
Had a mess.
She was your brother's wife.
She was a suicide. Cut off her head.
Holy crap. That's his sister-in-law. And he just probably stole the money. That's so undignified, right?
Your brother? You have spoken to him?
On what matter, my lord? He is still arrested.
Yet you did not mutilate the person. You must release your brother. I cannot do without him.
My brother is possessed by the devil and must be examined.
Your brother is as mad as you are. He grieves. And give him this. And tell him that he is at the very center of my prayers.
He's going to steal even more money off his brother. Orlando Bloom, but more interestingly, I love this song or piece of music. I've heard it somewhere before. It's probably his wife. Wow, what an amazing transition.
The bishop needs
that means she's dead and that's his brother. That was a lot of visual exposition. Look at the sets, man. Wow. And knowing Ridley Scott, it's mostly practically done.
Saracens, as you call them, have now unified in Egypt, Syria, and all Arabia.
Balian, the eldest. His child died. His wife fell into a... She killed herself.
Balian is Orlando Bloom's character. So Balian was a blacksmith.
Her grave was here. I'm afraid I can't tell you the exact location. I wasn't present at the burial.
Liar! Huh? What's wrong with him?
That is a sin!
Oh, man. I don't even know how you get over a lost child. That's beyond my comprehension. More technical note, I wonder where they're shooting these amazing, amazing landscape shots. This is clearly not somewhere in the US.
We shall work.
He's trying to distract himself with work, I guess.
We need all these horses shod. We need food, and we'll pay.
He has made war machines that cast the largest stones.
Now the brother is stalking him up. What a snake.
He would be one of the few on your journey worth more alive than dead.
Shut the heck up.
Shut up.
Have you been at war?
On horse.
So Liam Neeson plays a crusader knight, I think? Yeah. Ridley Scott's a very music-driven director, and I love it. He can evoke emotions by using a score. Looks like he was married a long time ago, and he used to live here, from that mini flashback.
God has made us man. We must suffer all. I also have lost. Some say Jerusalem is the very center of the world for asking forgiveness. I knew your mother.
Is he his father?
To be courteous, I should say that it was against her objections that I was the Lord's brother, and she had no choice. I did not force her.
Holy crap.
I have forgiveness to ask of you.
That was a revelation I did not see coming.
If you will come with me, you will have a living, and you will have my thanks. There it is.
My place is here.
Yeah, he's too depressed.
I want nothing.
I am sorry for your troubles. God protect you.
He's going to change his mind, isn't he? But how? Why? Is the question.
Jerusalem is easy to find. Come to where the man speak at Tidon. Then continue until he speaks something else.
The village does not want you. When the old lord is dead, they will drive you out.
It's not like you're trying to drive him out too.
If you take the crusade, you may relieve your wife's position in hell. Oh, what she does there without a head.
Oh no. Found the cross. His wife's cross. Wow, what a scene. Everything about that scene was amazing. From the lighting work to the actual pyrotechnic stuff. He just committed murder in the eyes of the village, so he has to leave and find his father to join the crusade. But yeah, I don't feel sorry for the priest at all. He was barely a real priest anyway.
I have done murder. Is it true that in Jerusalem I can erase my sins and those of my wife?
He wants redemption.
We can find out together. Pick it up. Let's see what you're made of.
Never use a low guard. You fight well. Take a high guard, like this. The Italians call it La Posta di Falcone. The blade isn't the only part of a sword.
Invaluable lessons.
Attack.
Jeez.
You have with you a man, Balian, who killed a priest, his brother.
Yeah, that's not gonna happen.
What he says is true.
If you say he's guilty, then we'll fight.
Uncle, he's a murderer.
Whoever dies here today, you will certainly be among them.
Yeah. It's a clear ambush. They're surrounded. Dude! Liam Neeson's shot. Dude's got an arrow going through his neck. Amazing fight choreography and camera work. Oh man, they're all dying.
I am accorded the privilege of ransom.
He doesn't care.
This is true.
Goodbye. You're about to be beheaded. Oh no! Oh, that was hard to watch. A pickaxe through the head.
In which case you'll take a fever and die. Or a cyst will form. You're in the hands of God.
Get me some more wine.
Yeah, he's gonna die. It doesn't look too good.
But they had no right to take you. It was the way they asked.
They had the right to take me.
And so do I.
To kill an infidel, the Pope has said, is not murder. It is the path to heaven.
Yep. Justify killings from all sides. That's definitely a crusader.
Who is this?
My son.
Would I had fought you when you were still capable of making a bastard.
I knew your mother when she was making hers. Fortunately, you're too old to be one of mine.
Ouch. Wow, look at the size of these sets, and I'm sure the ships in the background are visual effects.
Whatever your position, you are of my house. You will serve the King of Jerusalem.
What could a king ask of a man like me?
The Kingdom of Heaven.
Huh.
There is peace between Christian and Muslim. My son, you are all that survives me. Do not disappoint me.
Interesting.
Who are those men?
Muslims.
They're praying.
Saracens.
It's like our prayers.
Well, you both are Abrahamic religions, right? So I'm not surprised.
When the king is dead, Jerusalem will be no place for friends of Muslims or traitors to Christendom like your father.
They want to conquer everyone and kill the Muslims, whereas Balian and his family are more tolerant. He's officially naming Balian his heir.
Be without fear in the face of your enemies.
Safeguard the helpless and do no wrong.
What an amazing performance from Liam Neeson.
And that's so you remember it.
Arise, a knight, and Baron of Ebelin.
He's now the Baron with his father's sword.
Defend the king. If the king is no more, protect the people.
That is your purpose. This is a weirdly emotional scene. I wonder whether this scene made it to the theatrical cut.
You sail now for Jerusalem as your father wished. I'll follow within the week.
So, are they trying to cross the Mediterranean? Holy crap, did their ship sink? That sequence was a little hard to follow. Yeah, their ship sank. I wonder whether Ridley Scott is taking the same direction with this movie as he did with Gladiator. He's now a baron, but now he has nothing, and then he'll have everything by the end. Yeah, he has nothing but his name, just like Maximus from his Gladiator.
Since that is his horse, I have no desire to fight.
Yeah! Yeah, that dude's dead.
You have taken it very well that I have killed your master.
It was the end of his time.
Huh.
All is as God wills it.
Huh.
Take me to Jerusalem.
I wonder how much of this is CGI. I'm guessing a lot, but it looks fairly convincing. It's really amazing. The scale of the production, that's the most amazing part of the film so far.
A very good boss.
Take the boss.
I am your prisoner, your slave, should you wish it.
I have been a slave, or very near to one. I will never keep one nor suffer any to be kept.
Your quality will be known among your enemies before ever you meet them, my friend.
Wow, what a line. That's one of the highest compliments that you can get back in those days, right? Is he getting recognized? I mean, it's probably a famous sword, right?
Since you carry Godfrey's sword, you must have known him.
It's his son.
Come with us. My lord.
Oh, looks like he's arrived at his father's seat. That makes sense. Is that Eva Green? I think so. Yeah, you can tell from her eyes.
Give me some water. If you happen to see Balian, the son of Godfrey, tell him that Sibylla called.
It's exactly who you're talking to, but it's interesting he didn't identify himself.
It seems I've lost my religion.
By the word religion, I've seen the lunacy of fanatics of every denomination be called the will of God. I've seen too much religion in the eyes of too many murderers.
Interesting.
What God desires is here and here.
Looks like he's more secular than his contemporaries. I like that.
The king has made a peace with Saladin these past 6 years. He holds Jerusalem as a place for prayer for all faiths.
Those Templars have been hung for a raid that I know you commanded. Prove it.
He doesn't deny it, though.
He was my friend. I'm yours. What know you of Saladin?
That he is king of the Saracens, and that he surrounds this kingdom.
He united the entire Arab Peninsula, if I'm not mistaken. Is that the famous building, the Dome of the Rock in Jerusalem? I think so.
The Princess Sibylla of Jerusalem and her husband, Guy de Lusignan.
Oh, Eva Green's character is married to Reynald.
Do you go to meet Reynald?
No, my lord, he is in disfavor. I am a member of this court.
Oh no, this is not Reynald, this is Guy.
I loved your father, and I shall love you. A woman in my place has two faces.
Public and a private?
He was there when, playing with the other boys, my arm was cut.
Oh, dude.
And it was he, not my father's physicians, who noticed that I felt no pain.
He's a leper king.
The Saracens say that this disease is God's vengeance against the vanity of our kingdom. If that's true, I call it unfair.
Damn.
You play?
No wonder this king has very little agency and respect among his men. They think he's a leper and cursed or something.
When I was 16, I won a great victory. I felt in that moment I would live to be 100. Now I know I shall not see 30. None of us know our end, really. When you stand before God, you cannot say, but I was told by others to do thus.
Your actions are your own responsibility.
I will.
And then from there, you will protect the pilgrim road. All are welcome in Jerusalem. Not only because it's expedient, but because it is right.
Wow, a tolerant king. How rare. That was another beautiful scene, by the way. I wonder whether that made it to the theatrical cut or not. Yeah, I have to watch the theatrical cut to see the differences. Because this extended director's cut has been fantastic so far. A little slow, but it's working. He's arrived at his father's lands. Oh, it's in the middle of the desert.
My lord, you have 1,000 acres.
What we do not have is water.
It's dry. Wow.
I expect your hospitality.
It is given. Latif.
Is she like falling in love with him or something? How does that work?
But this isn't adultery. It's washing.
That's the first thing you say. This isn't adultery.
quote.
It seems years since I've seen a woman eat.
I've met your son.
Oh, the child was not the king's son, but hers. And Guy is her second husband. Beautiful score again, by the way. This is, earlier we heard more European-inspired medieval music, and this is more Middle Eastern-inspired music. Look at the transformation, it's all green now. It was all dry and brown before. So it's been a while. And she's definitely into him.
I could stay here forever.
This house is yours.
Why do you think I'm here?
Please correct me if I'm wrong, but I believe she's the king's sister, right?
They've seen us. Go after them. The rider is getting away.
It's a broad desert. Nothing will come of it.
Yeah, they're just attacking peaceful people.
Saladin will come into this kingdom.
Tiberius knows more than a Christian should about Saladin's intentions.
Saladin has crossed the Jordan with 200,000 men.
We must meet him before he reaches Kerak.
I think he's playing to both sides. He wants these extremist crusaders to believe that he'll fight, but he's actually going to negotiate with Saladin.
What becomes of us?
Nothing.
The world will decide.
Kerak Castle, stronghold of Renald. He looks a little delusional, if you ask me.
If we do, these people will die.
We'll hold the Saracen cavalry until the king arrives.
Wow, look at the scale of the production, the number of horses. And it all has to be coordinated. Yeah, they're surrounded. I mean, Balian has to survive, right? We still have half the movie to go. How does he get out of the situation, though?
Your quality will be known among your enemies before ever you meet them, my friend.
Holy crap!
You were not that man's servant.
No. He was my servant.
Wow, what a reveal! What a way to reveal it.
You may go into Kerak, but you will die there. My master is here.
The king is here. The king and Saladin are going to meet face to face. Wow. The shot.
Saladin.
The man himself.
Reynald of Châtillon will be punished. I swear it.
He doesn't want to escalate.
Withdrawal, we will all die here.
I am Reynald of Châtillon!
Give me the kiss of peace.
Oh, that's a sure way to get leprosy, but he has no choice.
Reynald of Châtillon, you are arrested and condemned.
Yeah, the king's on his last legs.
I need you in Jerusalem.
Intermission! I knew it! If it had an overture, it has an intermission. Does the theatrical version have an intermission too, or is it just Ridley Scott's cut? Intermissions in modern movies are exceedingly rare. I can't even name one. Out of the old movies I've seen on the channel, only one, I believe, had an intermission. Ben-Hur. So far, the film has been excellent. I don't know why it got a crappy reception when it first came out. I'm actually trying to think of weak points in the film. I mean, the pacing is slow, I'll have to admit. But the scale, the production, the score, the acting, the props, the costumes, they have all been excellent. Saladin's encampment.
Why did we retire?
He's asking, why not just attack then and there?
Numbers. The absence of disease and the availability of water.
A rational man.
How many battles did God win for the Muslims before I came? That is, before God determined that I should come.
That's because we were sinful.
Sure.
It is because you were unprepared.
Correct.
If you think that way, you shall not be king for long.
You can pray all you want, but if you're unprepared, you'll lose.
Thank you for your visit.
You promised to return Jerusalem.
Don't forget.
Who is this, though?
When he is dead, the boy will become king of a kingdom he cannot control. The Christians will make the war.
Everybody's itching for the war except Saladin and that king. Could anybody in the comments please tell me which crusade this is? It's clearly not the first or second, because those happened in the 800s-900s. And it's definitely not the last crusade, so it has to be one of the middle ones.
I am Raymond of Sadio! Raymond of Sadio!
Condemned to die by the king himself.
Plague us as death comes. Your confession, my lord.
I shall confess to God when I see him, not to you.
You sometimes dream you are my wife. Let's pretend you are.
Ugh. It's not like she has a real choice here, right? But then again, the wife's also cheating on him, so who am I to judge?
Your lover has 100 knights and the love of the king. I, the largest force in the kingdom, and the support of the Templars.
If I leave the army with Guy, he will take power through my sister and make war on the Muslims. We have decided that you shall take command of the army of Jerusalem. Would you marry my sister, Sibylla, were she free of Guy de Lusignan?
And Guy?
Well, Guy has to go.
He will be executed.
I cannot be the cause of that.
Why do you protect him? He's a man who insults you.
I wouldn't hesitate to kill you. By refusing to marry Sibylla, he's actually causing a bigger war. It's unfortunate, but at least his honor is intact.
Who are you to refuse a king? I will have power without Guy or with him. You say no.
It's a hard no for him.
Do you think I'm like Guy?
Ouch. I mean, she's in love with you, but she has her motives, right?
There'll be a day when you will wish you had done a little evil to do a greater good.
I can't argue with that.
The king will see you.
No, I can't.
Go, madam.
Yeah, it's his final hour. Dude, no! The kid also has leprosy. He didn't feel the fire, just like the king. Oh no. The kid's going to die early too.
You were beautiful, boy.
My beautiful sister. I've missed you.
Dude, this movie has a lot of emotional scenes. Very in line with Ridley Scott's work.
If my son has your knights, you have your wife.
Oh man, she has no other choice. Another beautiful shot. Yeah, I'm pretty sure it's CGI, but it's so well done in Ridley Scott films. Oh man. That's messed up. No modern medicine. You get a small disease and the next thing you know, you're deformed and dead. The poor kid. Nobody even knows that he has leprosy. Well, at least Guy will like that, right? Oh no. Oh no. They see he isn't hurt from the boiling hot wax.
How did my boy deserve it?
The gods will it. Dude, no way! She's poisoning her own son, giving him a merciful death. That's what she meant by, I'll go to hell instead. Did this really happen in real life, or is Ridley Scott taking more creative liberties here? I need to read up on it. This is messed up. Yeah. Guy's men are here to kill him. Look at Reynald, he's going crazy.
Give me a war. That is what I do.
He's going to free Reynald.
With the help of God, he will rule his people well.
And he gets what he wants.
Someone has to be.
He's justifying his actions. using religion. Like 1,000 men before him. Million, probably.
Salah Hadin's sister.
Salah Hadin Ahi.
They've got a sister.
Speak.
The level of arrogance in his voice.
The Sultan demands the return of his sister's body. The heads of those responsible.
They killed her. Yeah, he's gonna
this.
Die. You never shoot the messenger.
Assemble the army!
And there's your war.
No. If you must have war, this army cannot move away from water.
Makes sense.
Salah Hadin wants you to come out.
Fight him in the open.
So we shall.
Without my knights, then I will have the glory, Tiberius. You had yours.
Such a bad idea to leave the city walls, leave the city undefended, and just to march out and meet your enemy in the open battlefield.
When Salah Hadin has finished with Guy, he will come.
The boy is dead.
When the king is dead, his responsibility is to protect the people.
She let him go, and Jerusalem, along with him.
You go with the army?
My order is with the army.
You go to certain death.
I shall tell your father what I've seen you become.
Yeah, he's a good guy. I was confused about his allegiances, but he's a good dude.
When Saladin comes, we're not defensible.
Well, she knows what's going to happen.
Save the people from what I've done.
I will.
Yeah, they're running out of water already. It's really powerful imagery.
God wills it.
God wills it. Just like the Crusaders, Saladin's men also believe the exact same thing. How many lives have been lost to religious wars, right?
Can you sense it?
There has been no messenger.
It's the calm before the storm. Oh, we don't get to see the battle. The Crusaders have been defeated. Just like pretty much everyone predicted. Dude, he's still alive. And he gave him the respect of letting him live. Oh man, Renault is dead. That dude in the background, who is that? He seems to be enjoying it. Holy crap.
I've given Jerusalem my whole life.
Tiberius.
There is no more Jerusalem.
What are these, markers? Yeah, I think there are markers. He's setting up the defenses. We're about to see the size of Saladin's army, aren't we? Holy crap! It's insane.
We must leave the city.
How exactly, my lord bishop?
The fastest horse is from a lesser gate.
Coward.
It is unfortunate about the people, but it is God's will.
Right.
None of us took this city from Muslims.
It was your forefathers.
What is Jerusalem? Your holy places lie over the Jewish temple that the Romans pulled down.
True.
We defend this city not to protect these stones, but the people living within these walls.
We have no knights.
Truly. Kneel.
He's going to start knighting commoners.
Be without fear in the face of your enemies.
And the same oath given to him from his father.
Safeguard the helpless. That is your oath. And that is so you remember it.
Doesn't making a man a knight make him a better fighter?
Yes, belief does. Man, these sets are so elaborate.
If you survive, Ibelin is yours. I confirm it.
But it is a poor and dusty place.
Another emotional scene I did not see coming. If I was living back in the day and I saw that outside my window, I don't know, man. I'd be crapping my pants. I'd be running in the opposite direction, regardless of water. I mean, Ridley Scott wasn't kidding when he said this is an epic. Look at the scale of these things. Look at the explosion, seriously. Although the movie's a little slow, everything else has been just so good.
Force him to offer terms.
What terms?
We fight for the people, their safety and freedom.
I mean, they know they have no chance of winning, so they want to just wait it out, to tire Saladin's army. Like, at one point they have to negotiate. At least that's what Balian is betting on. But the siege towers are here, which isn't a good sign.
Mercy. No, I cannot.
Oh man, what a great insult. That's what the markers were for. They know their range. Yeah, the scale of this battle is incredible. Yeah, I don't think there's a real chance. They're massively outnumbered. Probably 50 to 1. How brave do you have to be in the front line of a war? Holy crap, battering rams!
Godfrey nearly killed me in the Lebanon. I did not know he had a son.
And that was very symbolic of the moon being on top of the cross. And the battle for Jerusalem will never end. It's still going on today, 1500 years later. I also like the fact that Ridley Scott is treating the character of Saladin with respect. Wow. I have no idea how they filmed this with so many real people. I'm sure there's a lot of CGI and compositing work going on. I'd love to see a making of this movie.
If we do not burn these bodies, we will all be dead of disease in 3 days.
It's all the same, both on the Christian and Islam side. God wills it, am I right?
If you throw down your arms, your families will die. Come on!
The wall has officially come down. I was waiting for this moment the entire film, but now that it's here, it feels kind of bittersweet. The Saracens have entered Jerusalem. Yeah, the cinematography in this scene is very visceral. That was another amazing transition. Ooh, a white flag.
Convert to Islam. Repent later.
Before I lose it, I will burn it to the ground.
Mutually assured destruction.
You will destroy your army here and never raise another. I swear to God that to take this city will be the end of you.
I will give every soul safe conduct to Christian lands. Ooh. Every soul.
Wow.
The Christians butchered every Muslim within the walls when they took this city.
I am not those men.
No, he is not.
Then under these terms, I surrender Jerusalem.
And there it is.
Assalamu alaikum.
What is Jerusalem worth?
Nothing.
No?
Everything.
Oh, that smile on his face. Oh man, that was an awesome scene. I mean, all this killing is senseless and all, but I like how dramatic Ridley Scott made everything. Who knows what happened in real life?
All will be safely escorted to the sea. If this is the kingdom of heaven, let God do with it as he wills.
I mean, at least he guaranteed the safety of so many people, right?
Decide not to be a queen, and I will come to you.
The perfect knight. Is that what you think you are, is it?
Dude, they let Guy go. And they're actually having a face-off. just like his father taught him.
Do it.
Oh, he's gonna show mercy.
When you rise again, if you rise, rise a knight.
Huh. I do not understand this. Could somebody explain that to me in the comments, please? Yeah, that's definitely symbolic. Wow, and so is this. Showing that he respects Christianity regardless.
It is not a very good boss.
It's his heart.
He will not keep it.
And it looks like Saladin kept his word about letting the people go. Oh, they're replacing it with Islamic symbols. Oh, wow. I love the score here. Wow. Yeah, in Islam, it's not dignified to walk over a grave or anything of religious importance. The queen.
A queen never walks.
She's given the titles up. Ooh, did Balian really end up with the former queen? Did that happen in real life? He's back!
We crusade to recover the kingdom of Jerusalem.
Another crusade! Just as the previous one ended.
We come by this road to find Balian, who was defender of Jerusalem.
Wow, Balian's famous.
I am the blacksmith.
And I am the king of England.
The king of England! There's that piece of music again. I don't know where I've heard it, but I've definitely heard this piece before. A reminder of his previous life. The King Richard, the Lionheart, went on to the Holy Land and crusaded for 3 years. His struggle to regain Jerusalem ended with an uneasy truce with Saladin. Nearly 1,000 years later, peace in the Kingdom of Heaven remains elusive. Directed by Ridley Scott. What a movie. Amazing. I knew it! Music by Harry Gregson-Williams. He also did the score for Man on Fire, which was amazing too. Thank you for pushing me to watch this, guy, especially the director's cut. It was so worth it. Okay, I took quite some time in collecting my thoughts. First off, that was an amazing film. And I can't believe I didn't take the time to watch it properly before. It was definitely worth my time, and Ridley Scott's direction here was nothing short of superb. Apart from the very long runtime, which I guess was necessary, I loved everything about this movie, starting with the story, the performances, the cinematography, the varied score, the camera work, the stunts and practical effects, but most importantly, the actual production end, like the locations, sets, and the sheer size of it all. Let's start with the directing by Sir Ridley Scott and the script by William Monahan. As you guys know, that I didn't watch the original theatrical cut, so I won't know why that version wasn't well received. I'm guessing a lot of things were cut. My review is just based on Scott's director's cut, and it was brilliant. These visionary directors do so much better without studio interference. I believe the same thing happened with Ridley Scott's Blade Runner and Gladiator. Do these studios learn nothing from lessons like this? That's a topic for another day. But for now, let's talk about some similarities I saw between the protagonists of this movie and Gladiator. Both Balian and Maximus, they're remarkably similar characters if you think about it. Both men lost their wife and child. Both were involved, let's say, with the king's sister. Both movies, kings. They had nephews who were next in line to the throne, but most strikingly, both these characters lost everything except their names and titles before they get it all back at the end of the movie. Maximus was a great general, and Balian here was a baron. I know it has nothing to do with this particular review, but I found the parallels very interesting. It's basically the hero's journey, right? Moving on to the rest of the plot, I don't know that much about history to be commenting on it, to be honest. I wonder how much of it was real, how much of the film was fictionalized. That's a question I asked several times during the movie. For example, did Sibylla really kill her own son or end up with Balian at the end? Was Saladin really this reasonable, sparing the Christians of Jerusalem? Was Reynald really that insane? Did Guy survive all the craziness at the end? What happened to him? I really need to read up on my history here. I'm sure that there were a lot of creative liberties taken by the writer and director. But on the other hand, I'm also sure that the broad strokes of the story were true, that Jerusalem was in fact taken by Saladin, and there were more crusades after the events of the movie. Whatever the case, Scott and Monahan came up with a compelling narrative to keep us invested for over, what, 3 hours? Thank goodness they had an intermission in the middle. And speaking of that, I did feel like the film was a little long. That's not a criticism in itself. I do realize why Scott felt like he needed so much time for like a 3-hour epic. It was to develop his characters and give them motivations for their actions, which worked extremely well all the way to the end. The performances by the entire cast was top tier. Not a single weak link in my opinion. While I enjoyed Orlando Bloom's acting, I thought Liam Neeson and the actor playing Saladin, I'm not familiar with him, did an even better job in their roles. Eva Green's Sibylla also deserves some recognition here. Not to mention the other famous actors like Jeremy Irons, Brendan Gleeson, and Michael Sheen. Even the hundreds, probably thousands of extras looked ethnically correct, for lack of a better term, and made me feel like the film was bigger than it probably was. The score by Henry Gregson Williams was amazing. Probably my second favorite work from him after Man on Fire, which was another amazing Ridley Scott movie. The score was varied and inspired by both Arab and European sounds. Two particular tracks caught my attention. I don't know their names, but I'll definitely be looking them up in the future. The song that played at the beginning and the end, and the other guitar work which played near the end. Anyways, finally, I've left the best for last, the production end, which was some of the best I've seen in the 21st century. Ridley Scott made Gladiator, a film I love, and I've seen the scale of that, and I shouldn't have been surprised, but I was. The scale of this movie was astonishing. The sets, the costumes, the props, they looked real. But what I was most impressed with, I guess, were the locations and how they were presented for the audience. The location scouting for the movie was some of the best I've seen in a long, long time. And I have no idea how much of it was real and how much of it was superimposed with CGI. And that's a huge compliment that I can't tell. Furthermore, to complement these locations, the cinematography and camera work were also equally good, especially those amazing battle sequences and landscape shots. Like I said before, I don't have any real criticisms here. I did feel like the movie was a little too long, but that's completely justified due to the excellent, excellent character work. Overall, Ridley Scott's Director's Cut of Kingdom of Heaven was a near masterpiece of an epic historical drama. While I understand that there were elements of fiction, it did not take away from the breathtaking scale of this picture. From the story, to Scott's direction, to the insane production values, the score, cinematography, and performances, I believe this film will rank near the top of Ridley Scott's amazing and legendary career. Although I wouldn't say that this was his best work, that's still either Blade Runner or Gladiator in my books, or at least in my opinion, this film comes really, really close. It's an easy recommendation. Anyways, thank you for watching. I have a Patreon page. Please consider being a patron. Subscribe to the channel. Click that bell icon for instant notifications. Do check out my other videos. Like if you like this video. Feel free to dislike it if you didn't. I will see you in the next one. Bye.